So do you remember that laser machine that could zap the shattered glass off of an iPhone in just a few minutes? Well, that same company made another machine that can remove scratches from cell phone screens. Now, we're all pretty familiar with scratches at this point. You know, they start at level 6 with deeper grooves at a level 7. Today, we're gonna test out this machine, see if it works, and see what level of scratches it can actually remove. Let's get started. So right off the bat, this machine is a beast. We're probably not gonna buy one of these for your living room, but at the same time, it's nice to know they exist, so if your screen ever has scratches, you can get it fixed. So inside of this machine, we have a polishing pad down here at the bottom, along with like a little coolant hose pump thing that we would normally see on like a CNC machine or a metal bandsaw. And the whole concept behind this is that we are going to remove a microscopic layer of glass off the surface of this display. And we're going to do that with science. We need something harder than a level 6 on Mohs scale of hardness. So in our particular case, we're going to use a super fine powder called cerium oxide. Each of these tiny pulverized fragments of dust are harder than a level 6 on Mohs scale of hardness. So we'll measure it out and add it to distilled water to make that magic sauce that removes scratches from smartphones. We're using distilled water because there's no minerals and it makes it slightly more safe for a cell phone. Even if a cell phone is watertight, you never really want to test its water resistance. It's dangerous. So if you're thinking about removing the scratches from your phone, you do have to weigh the pros and cons. One, you're getting rid of your scratches, but two, you're putting your phone in an abrasive liquid. Let's just see how it turns out. This is one of the phones I've taken apart for my durability tests and teardowns. As you can see from the scratches at level 6 and deeper grooves at a level 7. And there's quite a lot of other scratches since this phone is in use currently. So this is the before shot, and let's hope that the after shot looks a little cleaner. The white plastic mold is just to hold the phone secure while the machine is doing its work. And the blue goo, that waterproof sealant, is helping keep that milky abrasive from entering in through the microphone holes, around the edge of the screen, or through the earpiece, all of which are ingress points inside of the phone, which is where we don't want that milky liquid to be. Once we're done caulking around the edge of the phone, we can put it inside of the UV light, which cures the adhesive. Very similar to the adhesive we used on the glass-only Apple Watch repair we did last year. Once the adhesive is cured, we can take the plastic mold and drop it into the metal mold, which is what the machine grafts onto when it's doing the polishing. And since the waterproofing adhesive is now solid, the polishing abrasive should stay out of the foam.
So this is my first time using this machine, so it's going to be interesting to see how it goes. This puck right here helps keep the phone in place while we set it on top of the polishing pad, right up against those two wheels, just so you can see. Phone is still in there, and still alive for the moment. Position the abrasive spitter outer. Now we can turn it on, emergency kill switch, and I can hit start.
Now, I'm sure normally this is supposed to be down, but we're not about that life, so we're gonna go ahead and take a look from the inside. So right now we have the abrasive liquid, which we can kind of just spray wherever we want. This has a little magnetic base to it, but if we put it here in the center, the centrifugal force of the spinning pad kind of pulls the liquid out towards the edge, but the puck is also spinning around, and I assume it's spinning to kind of help remove that microscopic layer of glass uniformly across the surface without having lines running in a single direction. So we just finished 5 minutes in this glass resurfacer,
but I think it's time we see if the phone is still alive or not. It's got the liquid all over it.
And surprisingly, the level 6 and level 7 deeper grooves are both just gone. Now, of course, by removing a microscopic layer off the surface of the screen, we've also removed the oleophobic coating on the top of the glass, but we can bring that back easy enough. I'll take my razor blade and pop out the adhesive surrounding the phone. All the blue goo is turned into a hard plastic, and it's fairly difficult to get out, since the plastic mold is exactly shaped to the size of the phone. This, of course, is an iPhone mold, but I know they have molds made for other phones as well. To get that oleophobing back in place, all we have to do is clean off the screen really well. So you can see how the screen reacts when I add isopropyl alcohol to the surface. It just kind of stays in one spot and runs off the edge of the screen. But you can see it's sticking to the glass surface, which means that the oleophobic coating is gone. And that oleophobic coating is what keeps your fingerprints from getting the screen dirty. Once the screen is totally clean, then I can take the oleophobic coating, drop a couple drops on the top, rub it in, and then throw it in that UV light for another 30 seconds. And when it comes out, you can see that the alcohol, instead of sticking to the screen, is kind of beating up on the surface of the phone, which is exactly what we're looking for. Now the phone is pretty much back to the factory, scratch-free finish, and is still fingerprint resistant. Now I do have one of my iPhone XRs, and as you can see from the screen, we still have the level 6 scratches, with deeper grooves at a level 7. Now normally I stop at a level 7 because any more damage would be, you know, excessive. But I think today we can make an exception. If your phone ever sustained a level 8 scratch in real life, the reality is it would probably be broken. They're more like gouges in the screen. And well, a level 9 scratch is something entirely different all by itself. And a level 9, instead of being gouges, is more scoring the glass and cracking it all the way through. I doubt we can get rid of a level 9 scratch.
Alright, we have the level 6 scratches, level 7 deeper groove, level 8 gouges, and level 9 score across the surface of the glass. Let's see what can be removed. We have everything set. We're just gonna go for another 5 minutes on this round, but I wanna show you the back here. This is that milky abrasive liquid that is just being pulled up through the pump, through the pipes, all the way inside, through this adjustable spout. And once again, we're just removing a microscopic layer off of the surface of that phone. But is a microscopic layer enough for the level 8 gouges? Just if you were curious, this is kind of like a shag carpet. Just chilling there like a doormat. And the phone, it's nice and milky. Still turns on. Let's dry it off and put it under the light. So we can already see just from this lighting right here that 6 and 7 are already gone, but levels 8 and 9 are still there. Now personally, I think level 9 is gonna be there forever, but let's throw it in one more time for 5 more minutes and see if we can get level 8 to disappear a little more. It has now been 25 minutes. We left it in for quite a bit longer. So those level 8 gouges are pretty rough. And we made progress. Let's get it under the light. So it looks like the level 6 scratches and the level 7 deeper grooves are totally removed after those first 5 minutes. Minus the one little divot from the level 7 where I assume the pick just gouged out the glass a little bit. But the level 8 gouges and the level 9 score are still present, even after 25 minutes from the abrasive pad. So overall, I'm pretty impressed. The machine can probably handle scratches that happen to your phone with everyday life, you know, whether it's in your pocket or your purse, anything from a regular level 6 to a deeper groove at level 7, but anything that takes a chunk out of the glass, the machine's not gonna be able to handle. In reality, if you got a level 8 or 9, the screen's probably cracked at the same time, so you have a bigger issue on your hands. So if you've had your phone for a couple years and you want it to look like new again, there's a good chance that this machine can help you out. But once again, you gotta weigh the pros and the cons. You are putting your phone in liquid, and that could be game over. But with enough protection around the edge, it should turn out just fine. I'll leave a link for this machine down in the video description. This video is not sponsored. Huge thanks to Fixed for letting me borrow their machine for this video. And let me know what you think. Would you risk your phone to get rid of some scratches? I'm curious. Come hang out with me on Instagram and Twitter. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. And thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.